out your pet problems.
Huh, thanks, Doc.
Aw, he's a schnauzer.
Wow, how can you tell?
Well, Sharon, to be an expert in clean, you gotta know your competition.
For a deep-down professional-grade clean that's easy, rent a Rug Doctor today at your local Walmart. Rug Doctor today, for a cleaner tomorrow.
Here go my baby.
It's Charlie Wilson before you try and save it. It's another artist that me and Zach don't know anything about. When I pull up at the mall, couldn't find a place to
park. Threw my keys to the valet. I don't trust valets. They go through your ashtrays, take your change. Or maybe that just was, I did that. I don't know.
I'm sure that wasn't valet. That might have been somebody else that just offered to park your car on the street.
That just looked like a valet. Huh?
Oh, God.
All right,
y'all. Is there any way to zoom in on him? Like, zoom in on him when he's jerking and singing, trying to get the words out?
That's my jam right there, Uncle Charlie. If we got time for a story about myself and Uncle Charlie?
No.
No. No.
Okay. All right.
But you know what? I'm going to say this. So I believe in prayer and numbers.
Uh-huh.
So I think that social media is something that you can utilize for that. But when are you taking it too far?
Yeah.
When you're posting pictures of yourself or of your family members or your kids in hospital beds.
Oh, gosh.
This is something I've been conflicted with this forever. And maybe that's because I choose to keep certain things in my life private. But I just believe that there's certain things that should be kept amongst the family.
Yes.
And friends and loved ones. And I think people are starting to take things a little bit too far on social media. You know, and some of the people even too are people that I know. And yeah. It makes me want to unfollow their page because when you're posting stuff about you being in a hospital and you're not asking for prayers, you're just posting a picture of you hooked up to IVs in a hospital bed.
Wait, that's
with,
not funny.
With a whole status, you know, where you're just looking at the camera. You're not smiling. You're just staring at the camera.
Devastated.
But you took the selfie of yourself. You know, or you had someone take the picture of you in the state with the comment, oh, well, you know, doctor gave me Vicodin for my pain, might have to have surgery, but hopefully not. And that's just your post. I don't. What do you feel when you see stuff like this? Do you like? And then that's what I'm really conflicted with. Too.
You can't
like
it
on your picture.
Yeah, that's the truth though. Like I feel
girl, you
bad
look
for
good
liking
with them
it.
IVs, except for you.
Right. Yeah, I always feel bad because like you can't like it because that means I'm like, yeah, you're in the hospital with blah blah blah.
Yeah.
What do you do?
Well, you know, I'm gonna say this because I actually had a friend whose girlfriend, she posted something on Instagram where she was, you know, again, she was like in her nurse robe. Oh. She was doing Snapchat videos with filters.
Girl,
know,
look at this
right,
fluid coming
yeah,
out.
Right before having to go into her surgery. So I see this post, and this is the first time I hear about this. And this is somebody, again, it's my friend's girlfriend, but I know her.
Yeah.
I have her phone number. So I immediately sent a text. I said, are you okay? I said, I'm not going to respond to a post on social media. I'm not going to ask you anything or make a comment or like the post.
Right.
When I see it on here, I'm not going to double click it.
Right.
I'm going to text you and say, what's going
what
on?
What is happening?
And you know what happens?
What?
I don't get a response half the time.
But she on Snapchat twirling around with
yes,
fluids and
so
stuff.
In this specific situation, I actually, you know, I text. I didn't get a response for 2 days. So I text her. I called her boyfriend. I said, what's going on? I said, I saw this post. Is this a life-threatening? It didn't seem that way. She was smiling in the picture. But I saw the post. It seemed like it was serious. And I specifically said to him, I'm not going to text you. I'm not going to make a comment on social media. I'm going to call you
exactly.
And say, what's going on here? Because people that really care about you and people that you want to share that information with are people that are going to reach out and genuinely be concerned. So
and not
what I'm saying,
view your Snapchat filter.
Exactly. So are you posting this for attention? Are you posting this for likes? And when is it going too far with what it is that you're sharing on social media for people to see? Which generally half the people on your page, you're just, you know, accepting them as friends so that way you can look like you have a bunch of contacts. When half those people on your page you don't even know. But are these people that you really want knowing your business?
Right, because now you got little Kiki on there with her mesothelioma hooked up to Hy-Vee's on the hospital.
Wow, that was an interesting conversation.
You know, I mean, as much as you're on Facebook, do you ever see this, Tony?
I do see it, and I don't know whether to like it or not. But you mentioned nurse robes earlier. If any ladies out there want to send me some pictures with their nurse robe, unlike Michelle, I don't have a problem with it. I'll take all pictures with nurse robes on.
Well, let us know what you think. 491-0966. That's the hotline number.
Yeah.
Do you think that it's extreme for people to be posting pictures or videos in the hospital or in the doctor's office or in the dentist office, you know, with stuff in their mouth and they're kind of numb to the world or about to go under anesthesia?
Or in a health
clinic. Let us know what you think.
734, good morning.